In your pseudocode, you may want to write a computation, such as total cost equals purchase price plus cost of gas. You might want to have a decision if the total cost 1 is less than the total cost 2, do one thing, else do another thing. You might want to repeat certain steps while the bank balance is less than your target, or repeat some action, say 10 times. Those are the three essential elements of pseudocode: computations or other actions, without any regard of the syntax of a particular programming language. When you learn programming, there are two things that you need to learn: that syntax of the programming language and how to solve problems. And we'll do this in parallel on two tracks. In the next lesson, you'll learn quite a bit more about how to work with the programming language. But right now, let's learn a little bit more about algorithms, pseudocode, and problem solving. You've just seen an algorithm that manipulated numbers to give you a useful answer, but I thought it would be more fun to show you a few examples that don't have to do with numbers. So here is Robbie, our home robot. A robot is a computer too. It carries out tasks, and one has to program it to do the right thing. Right now, Robbie's task is to clean up a bunch of Legos. Robbie needs to put all the blue Legos before all the yellow Legos. Here's our first attempt at an algorithm. It's a sequence of steps. Robbie will wave his magic wand, and he will say, "Make it so." Well, that's not really going to work. An algorithm has to be executable and not involve magic steps. Our pseudocode here asks Robbie to repeatedly execute these statements, namely, while the blocks are not yet in order. Each time, Robbie is supposed to scan the sequence of blocks, find the first one that's yellow before a blue one, and swap them. So Robbie would go along, starting at the left, until it finds a yellow one before a blue one, swap the two, and then it would do it again. In the next step, it would scan from the left until it finds a yellow one before a blue one, and swap them, and again. Now I'd like you to try this. If I write a B for blue and a Y for yellow, tell me the sequence of the blocks after the next swap and the next one after that.